long, so if you guys have a couple of questions.
Before us leaving the relationship design.
I can hear you.
You can't hear me? Yeah. My name is Menta. I work with NBS.
Sorry?
My name is Menta. I work with NBS and Seneca. So my question is, as Jokis was talking about the relationship and stuff, have you ever been heartbroken before?
I mean, I've been hurt, but I don't think I've been heartbroken. I don't... Maybe I have and I can't remember. But I think you remember something like that. I don't know. Or maybe I'm just the kind of person that, you know, what happens, happens, and I keep it moving. But, like, I don't remember
how to
break. Answer would be different from someone that married someone that was a celeb when he became a celeb. When we started dating, we both of us, neither of us were celebrities. None of us, nobody really knew us. We're just, you know, in this little room trying to figure it out. So, you know, we came into limelight, you know, almost at the same time. So, the trajectory of our relationship was very different. There was no pressure of, oh, you're a celebrity. It just happened. Like, we're working and, oh, here we are. So, you know, chill. Okay. Oh yeah. I mean, you saw my face. I was very surprised because I didn't know it was my I think the weekend after my birthday, and so it was. I knew he was in the house with me that day, so he said he had an event, he had a show to be at. So obviously, I was surprised when he just popped out in front of me. You know, at the show. So that was very sweet. That was a very sweet gesture.
Yeah.
No. Is it Yoruba boy? No, I've never heard that. That is from Kenya. I've never heard that. But I can confirm that that is not true. Am I? Oh no. I feel like most of us Africans complain about our country. Is that privately or publicly? Because we want them to be better, right? I'm not a politician. I don't think I've ever had any aspirations in politics, but I'm passionate about our growth and, you know, us being better and us having better representation, because we're the people who are great, you know, and we need our countries to reflect that, you know, and I like to be the people about that. I have no idea. I don't know. All I know is that obviously his death was a terrible tragedy, and we hope that he can get to the bottom of it.
What is it that
I'm here for the...
What?
I mean, come on.
I have one.
Yep.
What do you have to say about the Ugandan music industry as an artist for Nigeria?
I'm going to say this as candidly as possible. I know that... I know that we have... Sometimes there can be some... You know, weird. I don't know what to call it. Maybe like some weird energy we see some African countries, because you know, like we're all the same people, but when you know we're represented outside of Africa, sometimes it may seem like, you know, some people have more. I'm making more noise, you know, as opposed to others. I mean, Nigerian. I only have the point of view of a Nigerian. Nigerian. You know what I mean? So I'm not going to speak like I know exactly what it is like here. That would be very disingenuous. That's not as fake. And I don't know how to be that way. I'm not a big listener of music either. It's just if I say if I wasn't married to my husband, I probably wouldn't know the songs. You know, but like I've heard a few people that have really piqued my interest. And I recently heard about Joshua Baraka. And that was nice. It would be nice if we have, you know, more African countries outside of Nigeria that would seep into our country the way our music also seeps into other people's countries. You know, that's something that we ideally would love. And I know that everyone here would love that as well.
Yeah.